भाजपा की नेत्री मेनका गांधी फिलहाल तो राजनीति से दूर हैं और हाल फिलहाल में उनका कोई बयान या किसी तरह की कोई प्रतिक्रिया सामने नहीं आई है, लेकिन मेनका गांधी उन नेताओं में शामिल हैं जो किसी भी मामले पर अपनी बात काफी मजबूती से रखती हैं और अपना पक्ष अच्छे से रखना जानती हैं। गांधी परिवार से जुड़े रिश्ते के बारे में बात करें तो मेनका और उनके बेटे वरुण गांधी को राहुल और सोनिया गांधी से हमेशा ही दूरी बनाकर रखते हुए देखा गया है। हालांकि कई बार ऐसा सुनने को मिला है कि वरुण गांधी और प्रियंका गांधी के बीच काफी अच्छे रिश्ते हैं और दोनों भाई बहन के बीच फोन पर बात भी होती रहती है। कुछ समय पहले बीबीसी को दिए एक इंटरव्यू में मेनका गांधी ने राहुल गांधी और प्रियंका गांधी पर खुलकर बात की थी और उन्होंने अपने बेटे वरुण गांधी को लेकर भी बयान दिया था। वरुण गांधी को इस बार भाजपा ने टिकट नहीं दिया था और वरुण गांधी चुनाव के वक्त ज्यादा दिखे भी नहीं थे। इस पर मेनका गांधी ने कहा था कि वो काफी काबिल हैं और वो आगे जरूर कुछ अच्छा करेंगे। मेनका ने कहा कि वरुण में काफी काबिलियत है और उनमें काफी समझ भी है। कई बार ऐसी चर्चा भी सामने आएगी कि वरुण गांधी भाजपा को छोड़कर या तो समाजवादी पार्टी नहीं तो कांग्रेस में शामिल हो सकते हैं, लेकिन इन सब बातों में कितनी सच्चाई है इसको लेकर मेनका गांधी ने कहा था कि वरुण फिलहाल भाजपा में है और उनको पता है कौन सा कदम उनके लिए सही रहेगा। राहुल और प्रियंका गांधी को लेकर पूछे गए सवाल पर मेनका गांधी ने कहा था कि अभी राहुल को और परिपक्व होना है। उन्होंने कहा था कि सिर्फ पदयात्रा निकालने से कुछ नहीं होगा बल्कि लीडरशिप क्वालिटी भी जरूरी है। जब प्रियंका गांधी के लिए सवाल किया गया तो मेनका गांधी का जवाब बिल्कुल सेम था जो उन्होंने राहुल गांधी को लेकर दिया था। हालांकि ये सारे जवाब मेनका गांधी ने लोकसभा चुनाव के दौरान दिए थे, लेकिन अब के जो ताजा हालात हैं उससे साफ पता चलता है कि राहुल गांधी में काफी ज्यादा परिपक्वता आ गई है और जिस प्रकार से वो संसद में नेता विपक्ष बनने के बाद अपने भाषण दे रहे हैं तो उसे देखते हुए इस बात से इनकार नहीं किया जा सकता कि राहुल गांधी के तेवर काफी हद तक बदल चुके हैं और अब वो पहले से कहीं ज्यादा मुद्दों को बेहतर ढंग से उठा रहे हैं।
A child commits a crime in the heinous category, which is murder, rape, some kinds of arson. Suppose he commits that, he will then go before, and he is under 18, he will go before a juvenile justice board. The board does not have police on it, it doesn't have lawyers on it, it has psychologists, it has social workers, it has experts. Their job is not to condemn him or anything. They will decide whether he committed the crime with an adult mind or a childish mind. For instance, to give you an example, if someone's father has been coming home every day and beating the mother, and stubbing his cigarettes out on the child. And one day the child just gets up and has a fit of temper and he picks up a bottle and smashes it on the father's head. Then, and the father dies. Is this a heinous crime? Murder is. But did he commit it with a childlike mind or with an adult mind? Obviously with a childlike mind. It's an unthought of, spur of the moment crime in retaliation for perceived injustice. Now, if the board decides that this child committed this crime in a childlike fashion, even if it is rape, for instance, he was committing it because he was being egged on by people older than him, as a bet, as something that might be perceived as childlike, he will get the benefit of the doubt and go in for 3 years into reform school, as the Nirbhaya boy did. If it is perceived that it was a thought out adult, mature crime. For instance, last week, a little girl, age 7, was fed biscuits laced with drugs by 3 boys, age 16, who then took her to a field, kept her there for 3 days while repeatedly raping her. Now, this in no way would be constituted as a childish crime or committed by children. It has been thought of, it has been planned for, and it has been executed in an adult manner. Those 3 children, for instance, I'm sure the JJ board, in its wisdom, would decide should go into the adult system. Once they go into the adult system, please bear with me, this does not mean, again, that they will go to jail. The adult system, they are provided with lawyers, or should their parents decide, they can get their own lawyers. They're provided with the same access to justice as adults are. These children will then appear before court, and the court will decide whether they are to go in to an adult system or to a juvenile system. So again, they get a second chance. If, for instance, the court decides that they are to go into adult jail, even then they have the power of appeal as anyone else, High Court, Supreme Court. At the end of this this all these steps, if it is decided that they are to go to adult jail, they will still not be put into adult jail along with adults. They will be put into a children's jail, a bostel. At the moment, a bostel doesn't exist because no child has ever gone to a bostel. But the system will create it. Once they go into bostel, they will stay there. And please, again, listen. They will stay there only till they are 21 years old. If at the age of 21, there will be another check on them. And if that check decides that they have served their sentence, that they have now reformed, that they are no longer, we no longer need to have them locked up, they will be released. If it is decided that no, they're completely recalcitrant, they have learned no lessons, and they still are of that criminal bent of mind, then they will serve their full sentences, whatever they are. This is the bill. You cannot get more nuanced and more compassionate than this. Today, the whole of India is in a somber mood. We have the parents of Jyoti sitting here watching us. Why are they such special people that we listen to them? Not because, listen. Okay, maybe I shouldn't take names. Not because their daughter died, but because they sold their land to have her educated, which means that they're far-thinking, modern, good human beings. This is not, as a member of parliament so correctly pointed out yesterday, it's not a retrospective bill. We can do nothing about that young man. He will come, he will go his own way in life, and God willing, be a decent citizen after this, if it's possible. But it will stop a large number of boys who have got into this. The newspapers will tell you that this is the juvenile involvement in crime is the fastest rising segment of crime out of all crime. All police people that you talk to will tell you that children walk in every day into the police station and they say, "Humne ji qatal kar diya, humko JJ bhejo." My driver, the ministry driver, saved up for 4 years and bought a car, a small, dinky little second-hand car. 3 months after he bought it, it was stolen. We contacted the police, and amazingly, the police found his car after a month, called him at 12 at night, and said, "Come and see whether this is your car." So he went, and the person where the car was, the person who had stolen it was a 16-year-old, and there were 5 cars, motorcycles and scooters in the same compound. And the police said, "Iske saath kya kare? Ye to abhi bhi bol raha hai, JJ bhejo." So they said, "Hamare paas time nahi hai JJ ke mamle mein." They made him sign a bond saying, "Ki maine galati ki, main aainda se kabhi chori nahi karunga." The boy has been doing it with an older gang has been making him do this, and he has been doing it quite happily for the last 3 years. They're no longer even sending them to JJ. You have had the most telling part of this is that this boy was sought to be held further by the Home Ministry on the grounds that he had been radicalized by Kashmiri terrorists who are also in the children's home. Hum aapse ye poochte hain, what on earth were Kashmiri terrorists doing in a children's home? Has it occurred to anybody that those Kashmiri terrorists should not be in a children's home? But because they were 16 years old, they were put into a children's home. Now, are we going to make no differentiation? Aap terrorist ho, murderer ho, rapist ho, kuch bhi karo. Aap usi home mein jao aur ek dusre ko infection badha do. I can't make separate homes for rapists and separate home for young murderers and separate homes for young arsonists and separate home for young Kashmiri terrorists. I can't do it. They all go in together. Do we really think that these are children? You say, let a child be a child. And I'm saying, absolutely. But these children commit offenses against other children. We've had 6-month-old babies who have been raped by 15-year-olds. We have had 7-year-olds and 6-year-olds and 3-year-olds in this. Are we going to protect the victims or are we going to protect the criminals? Now, it just makes people safer. Not that these boys will all go into jail, maybe a very small percentage due to this bill, but it certainly will stop 16-year-olds from going into a thana and saying, "Maine ji jhuggi ko aag laga di hai, mujhe JJ mein dal do. Maine ji gaadiyan 50 chori ki hai, JJ mein dal do. Mujhe apne padosi ka balatkar kar diya, mujhe JJ mein dal do." These are self-confessed crimes, and every police thana will tell you that they're abounding with self-confessed crimes, because these 16-year-olds know that at the moment nothing can happen to them except a 3-year-old stint in a school, a reform school, where they go to normal school, come back in the evenings, and when they finish this, they will get money from the state to start their lives properly. And what will their victims get? Nothing. You have to decide. This is not my bill. This is not even my government's bill. This bill was started by you, finished by us, but it is a matter of the whole houses. Nobody remembers who passes a bill. Nobody. Nobody will remember Menaka Gandhi or any of us. They will remember that a bill came in. And therefore, think about what you'd like to do. Thank you.
और आप हमसे जुड़े रहने के लिए सब्सक्राइब करें YouTube पर, फॉलो करें Twitter पर और लाइक करें Facebook पर. और ज्यादा जानकारी के लिए आपको टाइप करना होगा सिर्फ न्यूज़ नशा.